Hello friends, welcome to Knowledge Hut. Quality is one of the modern project constraints which leads the project management processes and activities. Quality control experts depend heavily on the 7 basic quality control tools to improve the quality. Let's go through each of the 7 basic quality control tools one by one. First, cause and effect diagram. Cause and effect diagram, which is also known as a fishbone diagram because of its fish-like shape, is used for identifying the causes or reasons behind a problem. The head of the fish represents the effect. Suppose we are facing the problem of high defect rate in the organization, then the head of the fish will represent high defect rate. Then we brainstorm the broad categories of factors which can lead to this problem, like people, machine, methods, and materials. Then we brainstorm all the possible causes which can lead to these factors, like motivation and skill set of the people. These causes can also be further divided. In the end, you get an image of a problem with all the possible causes leading to it. You can now prioritize these causes and analyze the most likely causes to ultimately reach the root problem and its solution. Second, flowchart. A flowchart is a pictorial representation of the flow of a process. It can have process points, input points, and decision points. Using this diagram, we can understand all the steps involved in a process. This understanding can help us in coming up with better ways of performing a process. Third, checksheet. A checksheet is used to collect data in a systematic way. For example, you want to know various observations made by the testing team under various categories. You also want to know the frequency of those observations. Then you will have the categories of the observation on one side, and the frequency of their occurrence on the other side. The data collected through checksheet is then used further for quality improvements. Fourth, histogram. Histogram works on the same principle on which checksheet works. The additional feature offered by the histogram is the graphical representation of the data. For example, the data collected in our checksheet can be represented by this histogram. Fifth, Pareto chart. Pareto chart arranges the bars of the histogram in descending order. The cumulative total of the frequencies is represented with the help of a line above the bars. In quality management, this tool can be used for knowing important pieces of information, like most common sources of defects, most common type of defects, etc. Sixth, control chart. Based on your previous observations of a process, you determine the acceptable highest and lowest frequency limit of the occurrence of an event. These limits are known as the upper control limit and the lower control limit, which is plotted on the graph in the form of two different lines. In the middle, you have a line showing the average. Now, by plotting the current frequencies on the graph, you can understand whether a process is under control or out of control. Seventh, scatter diagram. Scatter diagram is used to see whether there is a relationship between an independent variable and a dependent variable. We plot independent variable on the x-axis and the dependent variable on the y-axis. For example, if you want to know if there is any correlation between the size of the project and defects per size, then you can plot the size of the project on the x-axis and defects per size on the y-axis. Now, if you see that the defects per size are increasing with an increase in project size, then you can say that there is a positive correlation between them. Between two variables, there can be a positive correlation, negative correlation, or there can be no correlation at all. So these were the 7 basic quality control tools for efficient project management. Thank you for being with Knowledge Hut. To stay updated with more such videos, click on our logo on your screen.